Welcome. I am Lourdes Perez, and this is the Voxfam Network. Today, I have the honor of hosting Palestinian visual artist Leila Kassab. And today begins the virtual solo exhibit in the Voxfam International Gallery. We'll provide links below.
مرحبا، أهلا وسهلا بكم. مقدمة هالبرنامج هي لوردس، الفنانة لوردس بيريز، واليوم رح تكون الحلقة على برنامج فوكس فام، شبكة فوكس فام، حول الفنانة الفلسطينية ليلى كساب، ويلي رح تحكي عن تجربتها من فلسطين، ورح يكون لاحقا بعرض للوحاتها الفنية بأونلاين، يعني عبر هيدي الحوار، ورح يكون في رابط متوفر بعد هيدي، يعني من ضمن هيدي الحلقة.
Thank you. Leila was born in Rafah, Gaza, occupied Palestine. Her family was pushed into exile from the village of Karatia.
ليلى مولودة برفح فلسطين المحتلة، وتم ترحيلهم من قريتها كاراتيا من قبل الاحتلال.
By way of introduction, we want to have Leila tell her history, her story to us.
فمن ضمن المقدمة بنحب إنه نسمع من ليلى قصتها.
أنا الفنانة التشكيلية ليلى صلاح كساب من مواليد مدينة رفح، مواليد عام 1985.
My name is Leila Salah Kassab. I am a visual artist. I was born in Rafah City in the year 1985.
Yes. متزوجة وعندي 5 أطفال ودرست علم الاجتماع بجامعة الأقصى.
I am married and I have 5 children and I studied at the Al-Aqsa University.
Yes. أنا بحب الرسم كثير وسماع الموسيقى وقراءة القصص والروايات، بس أكثر شيء بحبه هو الرسم.
I love arts, I love music, I love reading, and most importantly, I love to paint, I love to draw.
لأن الرسم هو الأكثر شيء بيعطيني مساحة إني أعبر عن قضايا الشعب، قضايا المرأة في المجتمع الفلسطيني.
This is because drawing or painting specifically allows me to express freely what my people are going through, what my country is going through, and all the issues and the difficulties that my community is going through.
طبعا أنا ما كنت محظوظة إني أدرس الفن التشكيلي، طبعا بسبب الحواجز اللي كان الاحتلال يضعها على الطرق واللي كانت تمنع الطلبة من الوصول إلى الجامعات.
It was not easy for me at all to study visual arts for the main reason because the occupying forces in my country would have checkpoints, many checkpoints that would forbid the Palestinian people from crossing over from one place to another. So this was a major obstacle for me to attend my arts study classes.
فطلب مني بابا إني أدرس أي تخصص ثاني وما أضطر إني أروح على مدينة غزة طبعاً بسبب الحواجز.
For this reason, my father forbade me from going to those art classes, risking my life because of the checkpoints. And he suggested, actually pushed me to go to study social work at Al-Aqsa University, which was much safer to do.
كانت هاي أسوأ 4 سنوات بحياتي، لأنه أنا ما درست الشغل اللي أنا بحبها.
This was the worst 4 years in my life because I wasn't actively studying the passion that meant the most in my life, which was painting and drawing.
فقررت إني أنضم لمؤسسة بتعتني بالرسامين، بتعلمهم النحت والرسم على القزاز والرسم بالألوان الزيتية.
So I decided to enroll into an institute, an arts institution, where passionate artists could study painting, drawing on glass, all the other crafty artistic materials. And this was without my father knowing, because I didn't want him to get upset with me.
كان هذا أحلى مكان بحب أروح، ريحة الألوان واللوحات واستخدام الفرشيات، كل هاي الأشياء كانت بتخليني أنسى إنه أنا درست شغل ما بحبه.
This was by far the most beautiful thing in my life at the time when I was attending the university, studying social work, which I didn't really like. On the other hand, I was able to secretly go to the arts institution, and I was in love, especially with the smell of the paints and the feeling, the texture of the paint brushes in my hands and the paper, the drawing paper. And this was for me my favorite ever part.
طبعا بابا عرف بالصدفة إني أنا انضميت لهاي المؤسسة، فقرر إنه يحبسني بالبيت، ما يخليني أطلع من البيت لا على الجامعة ولا على المؤسسة.
Wow. So by chance, my father found out, discovered what was happening. So he made a retaliation that in return, she would stop, completely stop going to both the institute, the art institute, as well as her university. And she was not allowed to leave the house for a while.
طبعا هذا كان لأنه خايف علي وحابب إني أنا أتفوق بالتخصص اللي أنا بدرسه.
Okay, this was all out of love. He wanted her. He was very, very afraid for her. He didn't want anything, any harm to come her way. So that for this reason, he made her stay at home and he wanted her to excel in her university studies.
طبعا أضربت عن الطعام تقريبا 3 أيام، ما كنت أطلع من غرفتي أبدا، في محاولة إنه يعني أقنعه إنه أنا إلى جانب دراستي أتعلم كل شغل تتعلق بالفن التشكيلي.
Okay, Layla's way of dealing with this was she went on a hunger strike for 3 whole days. Her aim was to make him understand, make her father understand that she would go to the university, continue her university studies, as long as she would be allowed to pursue her arts classes.
طبعا بعد هاي الفترة هو ما كان متعود يشوفني حزينة جدا ومكسورة القلب مثل ما بيقولوا، فما هان عليه، فطبعا سمح لي إني أدرس إني أتعلم شو ما بدي عن الفن التشكيلي بشرط إنه معدل الجامعي ما يتأثر.
Okay. So her father, because he loved her so much and it broke his heart seeing her so sad, let alone on a hunger strike, He decided to let her do her passion, let her pursue her passion in arts, in painting, in drawing, as on one condition, that this would not affect her grades, her excellent performance at her studies at the university.
ومن هاي اللحظة بدأت رحلتي كفنانة تشكيلية.
From then onward, her journey as a visual artist began.
كأنه الله أعطاني أجنحة إني أطير بعالم الفن.
It felt like God gave me wings and I flew as high as I could just for the sake of being an artist and producing artwork.
طبعا كان أول معرض إلي بعام 2006، كان هذا أول معرض بابا يشوف لوحاتي.
Wow. Okay. So my first ever exhibition was in 2006, and it was my father's first opportunity to actually see my artwork.
يومها لبسته بفلسطيني مطرز، كأنه التطريز بيحكي كل قصص الجمال الفلسطيني.
انت لبستي؟ On that day of the exhibition, my dress was purely authentic Palestinian stitches, a beautiful dress that gave me so much pride. And for her, it was the utmost happiest moment.
أخبرني بعض الفنانين إني كنت عاملة زي الفراشة.
Some of the artists, some of my art colleagues told her that she looked like a butterfly.
طبعا طبعا لما بابا شافني في المعرض حضني وبكى يومها كتير، حكى لي إنه أنا ما كنت بتوقع إنك تكوني بتحب الفن لهالدرجة.
Oh my God. So when her father saw her, he saw how elated she was, how beautiful in that typical traditional Palestinian dress and her paintings, that he embraced her so warmly and he wept. He wept and he told her that he never expected her to be such a passionate artist and that so determined and that she did it so well.
طبعا حابة أحكي إنه أنا عشت طفولة ما كانت يعني طفولة سعيدة كتير، فكنت بحاول دايما إني يكون إلي عالمي الخاص بعيد عن المشاكل العائلية والصراعات العائلية وهيك.
العائلية مش الوضع مش بس الاحتلال
يعني أنت
قصدي
بتعرف في
إيه.
مشاكل
اوكي
الحماية والحماس.
اوكي اوكي I have to mention that my growing up years, when I got married, I was living in miserable conditions. It was domestic, mainly domestic disputes, arguments, disagreements, and it was very sad time for me. And it was the only way, drawing and painting was the only way for me to isolate myself, to shield myself from all that sadness.
بدي أحكي لك بس إنه هاي المشاكل مش بزواجي أنا، هاي المشاكل كان بيواجهها بابا وماما طبعا، وكنت أحس إنه يعني بتأثر على جزء كبير من حياتي، بس كنت حابة إنه رغم وجود هاي المشاكل كلها إنه أنا يكون إلي عالم خاص فيا.
Layla wants to clarify more that this was not the disputes, the domestic quarrels were not related to when she got married and with her in-laws or that. It was way before. It was from the problems that mother and father had at home, and it was a daily struggle for her to deal with that. So therefore, arts and drawing and painting were her salvation.
طبعا بعد ما نجحت كفنانة تشكيلية إني أوصل للعالمية عام 2009، كنت بحس إنه أمي وأبوي كتير بيدعموني معنويا بكل شتى أنواع الطرق.
So in 2009, Leila became a worldwide known visual artist. And this made her mother and father extremely proud of her and therefore very supportive in any way they could. They would provide her with the support that she needed.
كنت أعبر عن قضايا الشعبي على الجدران.
I used to express my people's issues, problems, pains, all on graffiti. Was it graffiti, right?
Yes.
On the walls, painting them on the walls.
كنت أرسم بالشوارع لوحات على الجدران بتعبر عن حقوق الإنسان اللي إحنا بنفتقد إلها.
I would do street paintings, street drawings on the walls in the city to express human rights issues, which we were deprived of.
طبعا كنت بواجه كثير ملاحظات من المجتمع لأني كنت أول فتاة ترسم في الشارع في مدينة رفح.
Wow. Okay. So I would be criticized a lot in my city, in Rafah, because I was the first and only girl at that time who would do street arts. Yes.
كانت هاي مرحلة كثير صعبة بالنسبة إلي، بس قررت إني أتحدى نفسي وإني ما أسمع ملاحظات المجتمع.
It was a very difficult period for me being a street artist, but I decided that I would not listen to all of those criticisms coming left, right, and center, and I pursued what I love to do, to express myself on the walls of the streets of my city.
ونجحت طبعا إني أعرض لوحاتي ببريطانيا وأمريكا وفرنسا والسويد وإيرلندا.
And I succeeded in doing exhibitions of my paintings in the United States, in England, in France, in Sweden, and in Ireland.
Yes. وبابا كان كثير راح يكون فخور فيا لو كان عايش.
Oh, and if my dad was still alive, he would be so proud of me. خبرينا عن هاللوحة. Tell us about this painting. Oh, it's amazing.
هاي اللوحة بتعبر كتير عن قدرة المرأة الفلسطينية إنها تعبر إنها تحافظ على جمال التراث الفلسطيني وإنها تحافظ على أفكار حق العودة. طبعا مثل ما أنتم شايفين اللوحة فيها فراشات، هاي للشخص اللي بيشوفها لأول مرة هي فراشات بس هي مفاتيح العودة. طبعا
Okay,
أنت
let me. Okay, خلي. Okay.
هاي المرأة الفلسطينية بتحاول إنها تحافظ على أفكار اللي بتتعلق بالتراث الفلسطيني وخاصة فكرة حق العودة.
Okay. This painting mainly focuses, reflects the Palestinian woman's determination to reflect her heritage as a Palestinian woman, in her clothes, in her eyes, makeup, the flowers, the way she puts them. And also, you can see your first impression when you look at the painting, you see that it appears what appears to be a butterfly on her face. This is actually not a butterfly. Look closer, and you will find that it is a key. It's the key, and this is the part where this Palestinian woman is reflecting her right to return, the right of the Palestinian people to return to their homeland.
طبعا إذا بتلاحظي يا مي،
نعم.
إذا بتلاحظي إنه الفتاة هي قصة شعرها بشكل عصري، تمام، بس
ايوه
هذا ما بيمنع حتى لو تغيرت الأوقات والأزمان ومرت سنين طويلة على النكبة الفلسطينية، ما زال أطفالنا ما زالوا أجدادنا بيذكرونا بهاي الأحداث، ولازم إحنا كمان نذكر أولادنا بهاي الأحداث، ما لازم ننسى تاريخنا كفلسطينيين.
Thank you, bravo. Additionally, this painting, you will notice the hairstyle of the woman. It's trendy. It's not something traditional. And this is purposefully done, so because it reflects that from generation to generation, no matter how many decades pass by, Leila is explaining that the right to return is a message, is a right that is passed on from one generation to the other, to the other, to the next, and to the next. No matter how many years pass by, no matter how many generations it takes for that to actually happen. أوه.
حلو صح؟
تفضلي تفضلي جودي.
هاي اللوحة طبعا بتعبر عن أحلامي، أنا أحلامي الشخصية كامرأة فلسطينية بتحاول إنها تعبر عن قضايا شعبها، وبتحاول إنها تكافح لحتى تثبت وجودها في الساحة الفنية.
Okay. This painting specifically reflects Leila's dreams, Leila's ambitions and aspirations. It also, at the, in an overall sense, it also reflects the determination of the Palestinian women and the persistence to continue and to continue with their request for their fight for the right to regain their land, human rights, and all of that with dignity. Yes, Leila.
هاي اللوحة بتذكرني إنه جواتي كتير شغلات كتير حلوة، وجواتي قدر كبير من الجمال الداخلي وأفكار وأحلام كتير وردية. طبعا إذا أنتوا بتشوفوا القيود اللي بإيدي، هاي القيود هي ممكن تكون قيود من المجتمع أو من الاحتلال، لكن هذا ما منعني إني أحافظ على أحلامي طموحاتي.
Leila would like to add that if you notice the shackles that are binding her hands, she expresses herself before the talking about the shackles, that she's got so many beautiful inner feelings, so many beautiful images inside her heart that she wants to reflect, wants to share so badly with the rest of the world. And these shackles binding her hands can be shackles by shackles of society, or shackles, actual shackles by the occupation. So, but this does not hinder her, not for one minute, from realizing her or the other women who are as determined as she is from realizing their dreams. Leila.
هاي الشمعة اللي بجانب اللوحة ترمز للشغف، شغف كتير كبير وحب كتير كبير للفن وقدرتي إني أعبر عن قضايا شعبي، لكن هذا الشغف محبوس بسجن.
Looking at the candle at the bottom left of the painting, this represents the passion that she has This represents the ability to translate this passion and share it and set it free. But at the same time, as you can see, the candle is in a cage. It's caged. So you feel you want to share, you feel you want to break free, but at the same time, you're not able to do it just yet. Leila.
بأكد إنه دائما الإنسان بحاجة إلى إنه يكون عنده مساحة خاصة من التأمل عشان يقدر يرتب الفوضى اللي جواه.
Hello. Leila is she's saying something that is really, really, really deep. Is that it is very, very important for a person to have their own space, to own personal space. So that they could, tidy up the things inside oneself and be able to think clearly, to be able to move forward soundly and wisely.
The next, please.
Oh my God.
هاي اللوحة رسمتها كنت يومها بزيارة لستي الله يرحمها ويحسن إليها. طبعا هي كانت تحكي لنا عن شبابها وطفولتها اللي قضتهم بمدينة يافا.
اوكي
يافا طبعا تشتهر بزراعة البرتقال. طبعا أنا وطبعا أنا حبيت يعني أرسم ستي بأجمل صورة أنا بتخيلها. هاي مثل ما انتم شايفين طبعا هي كأنها جالسة تحت شجرة برتقال بتحكي عن تاريخ فلسطين لهاي الحمامة اللي بترمز للسلام.
الله. Okay, so this painting, Leila, one time she went to visit her grandmother, and she was inspired from the way her grandmother was, so loving. May her soul rest in peace. She drew her, she decided to draw her in this painting in her best ever youth, time of youth. And this is the best that, she looked so beautiful when she was young with her long hair and underneath the orange tree. And this is in the village of Yafa. It's called Yafa. And she loved, she always, Leila always used to love imagining her grandmother sitting under the orange tree, telling the stories of Palestine, of free Palestine, to this dove that she's holding in her hands.
Next.
This is the painting that talks about several issues, several aspects. First of all, it represents Gaza, the Gaza
yes.
that we know and the Gaza that we knew. Okay.
Yes. مثل ما أنتم شايفين في طاحونة. هاي الطاحونة هي اللوحة بعنوان طاحونة الأحلام. طبعا هاي الطاحونة هي بترمز للاحتلال اللي بيحاول إنه يقضي على أحلام الشباب الفلسطينيين ويحاول إنه يدمر مستقبلهم.
Okay, as you see, as you can see, you can you you can from the wheels, and it this represents from the wheels you can see there's something that's grinding. This is a grinding mill. Okay, above you see people,
yes.
Civilians. And
Yes.
and below you can see that what has been what they are ground, they've been ground, and this represents how the brutal occupation is responsible for grinding people, the Palestinian people's dreams.
حابة
Yes.
أحكي إنه بمجتمعنا الفلسطيني إحنا مجتمع كتير بيهتم بالتعليم. طبعا في عدد كبير من الخريجين بيتخرجوا سنويا من الجامعات الفلسطينية بمعدلات رائعة جدا، لكن لسوء الحظ هم ما بيقدروا يحصلوا على وظائف بسبب إنه الوضع في غزة بيخلي إنه من الصعب إنه الإنسان يحقق أحلامه على أرض الواقع.
Leila is saying that it is typically known, the Palestinian people, especially in Gaza, that they love education. It used to be a country of high education. Multitudes of students would graduate from the universities and only to be faced with the brutal reality that there are no job opportunities for them in the country, in Gaza.
The next, please. إذا أنت بتشوفي يا مي، هاي لمبة الكاز
أيوة
اللي كانوا أجدادنا بينوروا فيها بيوتهم.
أيوة
طبعا طبعا هاي بترمز أنا بحب أحط بلوحاتي دائما رموز خاصة بالتراث الفلسطيني. طبعا هاي اللوحة مليئة بالرموز الخاصة بالتراث الفلسطيني القديم، لكن هي بتعبر عن شغلة إحنا بنعيشها في قطاع غزة، وهي مشكلة انقطاع الكهرباء بشكل كامل عن قطاع غزة، وهذا أدى إلى توقف كتير شغلات في حياتنا، خاصة المستشفيات، يعني المستشفيات. طبعا إذا أنت بتشوف اللوحة فيها جانب مظلم وجانب مضيء،
ايوه
احنا بنحاول انه احنا بنحاول انه احنا نتخطى هاي المشكلة، نحاول انه احنا نصبر ونكافح لحد ما احنا نحرر بلادنا من هذا الظلم.
اوكي سؤال بس قبل ما اكمل ليلى، الشكل يلي موجود داخل القنديل الكاز، انا شايفه كاني شخص حامل المنجل، ما هيك؟ لا
لا لا،
شو
هو الشخص هو أنا شبهت النار
ايه
بأنها هي الشخص اللي بيروي تاريخ فلسطين
اوكي فكرت هيدا جزء من كمان موضوع الشغل، الاشغال، الزراعه ولا هيك. اوكي if you look at the lamp that in the painting it represents with the figure of a person inside. It not only does it represent a flame, of course, but also the person that in terms of the light that is through the information, through telling the stories of Palestine and all the beautiful things and the sad things caused by the occupation, the beautiful things that them as Palestinian people have done. And if you also notice the painting on the left side where you see the crescent moon, the darkness, there's darkness there. And on the right, of course, it's the light from the lamp. So they're trying from this, she's trying to explain that how they are struggling, how they are, you know, pursuing the dream of overcoming these huge challenges. ليلى كمان عم بشوف مفاتيح، كمان نفس الفكرة، ما هيك؟
هاي أنا تخيلت إنه أحلام العودة هي عبارة عن كأنها بذور داخل التربة تنتظر الوقت المناسب لتنمو، أو بإمكانك تتخيلها إنها أجنة ببطن أمهاتهم
أوه واو
وبنتظر إنهم يتم ولادتهم من أول وجديد.
Amazing. Okay, so you can also see the keys above the lamp, and including the butterfly with the key as its body. So Leila gave two explanations, two descriptions. The first is that they represent seeds that are waiting for the right time to fall into the ground and sprout into, you know, that it's time to come back, that people are coming back to their homeland. And they could also be representing fetuses inside the belly the bellies of their mothers, waiting for the time to be born, and in this case to be reborn as
yes.
the new Palestine.
The next هاي اللوحة هاي اللوحة بتعبر بشكل عام عن جمال المرأة الفلسطينية وحفاظها على جمالها رغم كل الظروف الصعبة اللي هي بتمر فيها. هاي اللوحة أنا استوحيتها من قصيدة لمحمود درويش، على هذه الأرض ما يستحق
الله
الحياة.
الله. Okay, let me translate. Okay, this painting represents the strength of the woman and her persistence and her eternal beauty and the endless persistence of holding on to the homeland or holding on to the promise to return to the homeland one day. This picture, this painting, Leila is saying, was inspired by a verse from the famous Palestinian poet Mahmoud Darwish, which I'm going to try to translate in the verse that she just told me. عَلَى هَذِهِ الْأَرْضِ مَا يَسْتَحَقُّ الْحَيَاةِ. On this earth, there is something worth living for. This is literal translation. في شيء ثاني بتحب تقولي ليلى؟
طبعا هاي اللوحة بتحتوي على رموز خاصة بقضية شعبنا، زي الطائر الأبيض، الحمامة، والقنديل المضيء. طبعا في بعنقها المفتاح اللي بيرمز لحق العودة، وبعض الأشياء اللي بتتعلق بالتراث، المعلقات، الأشياء هاي.
والسمك طبعا لأنه من البحر، بحر غزة، ما هيك؟
بس هاي السمكات مقيدين مقيدين.
مقيدين. Okay. The motifs in the painting, you can see the pigeon, the dove. This is all representative of the real Palestine. The lamp, the key in the necklace around her neck, which is the right to return, and the fishes that are dangling from the ornament, the hanging ornament. There are fishes from the sea, from the Gaza Sea, but also those fishes are shackled.
Yes.
They're trapped, all right? So, amazing. Anything else, Leila?
The next, please.
Yamma.
مثل ما انت شايفة، هاي مش امرأة، هاي طفلة. طبعا انا رمزت، حاولت اشبهها بطفلة، طبعا لما ربطت لها جدولين هيك او عكستين مثل ما احنا بنحكي، هاي طفلة. بس اذا انت شفتي ملامحها تشوفي واحدة عجوز،
اي
يعني بما معناه انه اطفالنا من كثر الاحداث اللي بمروا فيها والمخاوف والرعب اللي بمروا فيه بسبب الحرب، اصبحوا اطفال اطفال لكن بداخلهم عجوز.
If you look at the girl, this is not a grown woman. This is a young girl. This is a very young girl, actually, because, and she tried, and Leila tried to interpret this through the girl's hair, how they're ponytails, right? But if you look again at the girl, you'll realize that there's something about her that tells you that she's old. She's an old soul. Perhaps her eyes, they look weary, tired, because of all the horrors that the children of occupied Palestine have been through and going through. So despite the fact that this is a girl, maybe playing, sitting in a playful way, she's not well. She's inside her, she's really old. Despite the fact that she could be maybe 4 years old, maybe.
أتذكر إنه الأطفال في قطاع غزة بيعيشوا مأساة كبيرة جدا. يعني هاي الحرب الأخيرة على قطاع غزة قضت على أحلامهم، قضت على فرصهم إنهم يطلقوا تعليم كويس، قضت على أحلامهم إنهم يعيشوا في وطن آمن. يعني أصبح ما في تعليم، ما في أمان، ما في حتى لو ولو لحظة واحدة إنهم يحسوا إنه ما في خوف. لكن في طائر على كتف طفلة بيحكي لها إنه السلام قادم.
Oh wow, okay. Leila is further explaining that the children of Gaza have never experienced what it means to be a child before and now, as we speak. Those who died are gone, but those who still survive, they don't know what it means to be a child. This is something that is heartbreaking. The idea of having a dove on this child's shoulder is to tell her that hope is coming. Hope is coming one day.
The next, please. هاي
Okay.
اللوحة طبعا تشبه أول لوحة أنتو شفتوها، بس النسخة الحزينة منها، المرأة الحزينة
Okay.
اللي
Go ahead, go ahead.
هاي المرأة إذا أنت طلعت بعيونها هتحسي كأنهم واقعيين كتير وجواهم حزن كتير. طبعا سبب هذا الحزن إنه هي بدأت تفقد الشغف اللي في حياتها وفي أفكارها في مشاعرها في كتير شغلات. هاي الوردة اللي أوراقها بتتساقط هي حياتها، هي الأيام اللي بتمر من حياتها وهي فاقدة للشغف.
وكرمال هيك الدموع عم تنزل على الوردة، الوردة اللي عم تحضن دموعها. ما فيكي تحكي لي أكتر شوي ياما؟
طبعا طبعا هاي المرأة عندها كثير طموح وأحلام، بس هي تفتقد لشخص اللي بيدعمها ويحاول إنه يساعدها تحقق أحلامها.
اوكي
يعني كل إنسان فينا بيحتاج إنه إنسان يدعمه ويآمن بالأشياء اللي هو بيكافح من أجلها.
اوكي اوكي سو this painting is quite similar to the first painting I think that we saw with the trendy fringe and the hairstyle. However, it's the difference here is that she is a woman who seems to have started to lose her passion over time and started to lose hope, and hence the leaves and the flower petals are falling, are losing their strength, and the tears rolling down her cheek are going into the flower, and this represents that She's feeling desperate. There's a kind of painful despair that she's feeling she doesn't have the support she needs to be picked up and to be pushed forward, to have to regain that hope and that passion.
The next, please. Oh, هاي
Wow.
اللوحة، هاي اللوحة كتير بحبها.
Okay.
هاي اللوحة بتذكرني لما أنا كنت بالجامعة. طبعا أنا ما كنت حابة التخصص اللي أنا بدرسه، بس أنا بمرة من المرات صدفت إلي صديقة، يعني بنت هيك تعرفت عليها وأصبحنا أصدقاء، إلنا تقريبا 20 سنة أصدقاء. غيرت نظرتي للحياة تقريبا، أقنعتني إنه حتى الخدمة الاجتماعية أو علم الاجتماع أو عملك أخصائية اجتماعية هو فن، برضه
أها
ممكن نطلق عليه فن التعامل مع النفس البشرية.
أوف
طبعا طبعا إحنا بيوم من الأيام طلعنا رحلة وحبينا نكتب كل مخاوفنا برسائل، ويوم طلعنا بسفينة بالبحر حطينا هاي الرسائل في زجاجات، يعني بنحكي عليها جنية قزاز،
أيوة
رمينا هاي المخاوف بالبحر. هي هيك بتوحي اللوحة.
يا الله. اوكي brace yourselves. اوكي this is one of Leila's favorite paintings because it reminds her of her days at college at the university where she met her best friend of now of 20 years now. Her best friend, when they became best friends, she would explain and try to convince Leila that studying social work, community work, which Leila wasn't so particularly excited about, her friend would tell her that this itself, this kind of specialty or studying or major, is actually a form of art. In the way you communicate and help people, it's a form of art. So Leila started to think and, you know, change her mind about it when her friend spoke to her in that logic. So one day they were on the beach and they had a task to do, and which was to write on a piece of paper their fears, their dreams, anything, their pains, their joys, and they rolled them up and put them in these bottles that you see that are floating in the water. And they went on a boat further than the shore, and they threw out these bottles that would float in the sea. In that way, they would be like sending out, like wishing or sending out to the universe what they were feeling. And that's pretty much it. Kishitani, Leila, do you want to say anything else about it?
طبعا احنا لما عملنا هاي الشغلة، لما وصلنا الشط حسينا انه احنا تحررنا من كتير مخاوف.
So when they reached the shore, when they came back to shore, they felt so relieved, like huge burdens had been lifted off their shoulders after doing this task of writing and throwing the messages in the bottles for the universe to receive.
The
Very
next,
nice.
please. Thank you so much. Oh,
Okay.
حبيبي.
All right.
We have that piece.
هاي اللوحة بتعبر عن حبي الكبير للبحر، بحر غزة على وجه الخصوص. حسيت إني بحس إنه لما أنا بروح على البحر بحس إني ملكة البحر. هاي أنا. هي أنا
اه
ملكة البحر، جواتي أحلام كتير، وبحس إنه أصوات الموج ما هي إلا
الو
أصوات الموج. معك معك معك
كملي كملي بقى. اصوات الموج
بحس إنه أصوات الموج هي موسيقى، مش مجرد يعني أصوات موج، هي سيمفونية،
الله
سيمفونية إلهية بيتم عزفها. طبعا
عالي
أنا من عشاق آلة البيانو، نفسي
الله،
أتعلم العزف على البيانو، بس
وان شاء الله
في كتير شغلات بتضل أحلام، حلوة إنها بتضل أحلام كمان.
راح ترجم. This painting represents Layla herself. Layla has huge love for the sea, especially the Sea of Gaza. She loves the sea and she loves the sound of the waves, which is not, which to her coming, reaching her ears, it is not just the sound of waves, it's the sound of music, like a symphony. She specifically loves the sound of the piano playing. So she imagines that this is, it's transporting a symphony played on the piano. And she feels so free by sitting there on the beach and indulging in the scenery and in the sounds. شو كمان ليلى؟
طبعا طبعا اللوحة إذا ركزته فيها عدد كبير من الطيور، أنا بعشق كتير طيور البحر، النوارس البحر.
Oh yeah. Okay. Layla is saying that this, if you really focus, you can see several birds, which she loves. Can you see them? There's one. The wings are yellow. There's another one in front of it, and so she also adores birds.
Yes.
شو كمان ليلى؟ Anything else?
The next. هاي اللوحة طبعا بتعبر عن تراث، يعني بتعبر كتير عن التراث الفلسطيني بشكل عام، اللبس، شكل الوجه، اللبس، الوشاح الأبيض اللي بياخد على شكل علم فلسطين. طبعا بتعرفي هذه جرات الفخار كمان كانت موجودة
ايوه
عندنا
طبعا
لحتى الآن في ناس تستخدم هاي الجرات الفخارية بالطبخ، بالشرب المياه.
طبعا
احنا كتير كتير بنحب نحافظ على التراث الفلسطيني. طبعا هاي
طبعا
بترمز للمرأة الفلسطينية اللي بتحاول كتير إنها تحافظ على أصالة وعرق التراث الفلسطيني. لكن إذا أنت لاحظتي بمنتصف اللوحة في امرأة مجروحة تبكي، لأنه الاحتلال بحاول إنه يطمس هاي الهوية الفلسطينية، بحاول إنه يسرق التراث الفلسطيني بشتى الطرق. وإحنا يعني بنحاول دائما إنه نحافظ على تراثنا قدر المستطاع.
قلتي بحاول يسرق، ما هيك؟ يسرق
بحاول
التراث.
يسرق التراث، نعم.
ايوه ايه اكيد. This with flying colors represents the Palestinian woman who is rooted by her heritage and who takes huge pride in showing it off. You can see the beauty. The eyes, the eyelashes, you can see the scarf that is flying at the top, and you can, if you look closer, it represents the Palestinian flag design. So this is part of the Palestinian pride. Also, the clothes, the dresses, even the potteries that you see around, all of these things that Palestinians are
very rooted to and very attached to, which the brutal occupation tries to steal and make it part of their own heritage. And they try to either steal or just annihilate, simply annihilate. And if you look at the face of the woman in the middle, at the nearly the bottom of the picture, with a tear, a red tear in, down her cheek, this is the woman who is mourning what has been done to the beautiful land of Palestine. And how, you know, sometimes the struggle is, it gets so unbearable that you break down, but it doesn't mean that they don't stand up again and go and do as much as they can to promote their heritage, to show their heritage, and to make everybody who might think that this is not their heritage, this is the Israeli people's heritage. No, it is actually the Palestinians' heritage for thousands and thousands of years.